Hello, BookTube Nation. I'm Sam here again with Abernathy Books, and today I'm doing my Victober or Victorian October wrap up. So this was the first year that I officially participated, and I thoroughly enjoyed myself, so much so that I've carried Victorian reading into my November this year, but I'm absolutely loving it. I did finish two novels for Victober. One ran a little bit over, but that's okay. I'm considering this a win as I thoroughly enjoyed both of them. So the first one I would like to discuss was Agnes Grey, and that is by Anne Bronte. Now, this is my second Bronte book I've read. I've also read Wuthering Heights many years ago, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. I definitely intend on reading more of the Bronte books, especially Anne's other novel, as I've heard exceptional things about that one. But let's talk about Agnes Grey. So it was thoroughly readable. It was a fairly quick-paced book for a classic. I found myself just ripping through it. It was definitely, I would say, more on the realistic side of Victorian literature. It really gave you an insight into what it was like for Victorian young women who got into the role of being a governess. It showed you the different types of situations that you might find yourself in, but it was also wrapped up with a wonderful story. There is a bit of love story in there, so if that's something you enjoy. But if you're new to classics, I would also thoroughly recommend this because I found that it was really readable for a book written during the Victorian period. It's probably one of my favorites that I've read so far, and I definitely plan on reading more. The other book that I completed, and I was concerned because they both talk about governesses, I was worried that I would get confused, but that wasn't the case. And this is Ruth by Elizabeth Gaskell. Now this book, the other one, I would say was more of a fun read. I was more interested in what was gonna happen. But in Ruth, I felt like long-term, I may get more out of the book. It had a lot more discussion on character, a lot more discussion on how we should treat each other. And the ending isn't quite what you would expect. You're not gonna get that warm and fuzzy ending, though I felt that it ended the way that it had to. So I felt that it was very appropriate for the type of book that it was. I really enjoyed Ruth. I think that being someone of faith myself, I found it really interesting to look at how we perceive faith now versus how it was perceived then, and the changes in church and church politics. I don't belong to Church of England, but I've always found it very interesting to study. And there are dissenters in Ruth. It does kind of circle around some of the, it's not heavy in church politics, but it is kind of in the backstory. So I found that really interesting. I definitely want to get to Anthony Trollope's Barsetshire novels, because I've heard that those delve into that as well. And since I found that backstory interesting in this, I might find it interesting there too. But the main part of this story was about a fallen young woman. I hear that the ending in this one isn't quite as unhappy as Tess of the D'Urbervilles. I hear that that's handled a bit more severely. All around, I wouldn't say that it was an unhappy novel, but it definitely touches on things that affect us in life. It was very real. It was very emotional. I did find myself tearing up at one point during this book. I felt that though this one didn't keep me reading as quickly as the other one, I felt that I did in the end connect with these characters a little bit more, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. But anyway, so those were the two books that I finished for Victober. That was Agnes Gray by Anne Bronte and Ruth by Elizabeth Gaskell. And as these were my first two books for both of these authors, I have others that I can now look forward to. I'm currently reading an Anthony Trollope, which I'm really enjoying, and some other Victorian literature, which I will talk about soon in another video. So thanks again for being here with me today. I hope that everyone had a wonderful Victober if you were able to participate. And if not, I definitely hope you'll be able to join it next year. It is such a wonderful readathon. I'll link below all the hosts. They're all some of my favorite BookTubers. And definitely, if you haven't participated yet, check it out for next time. Farewell for now.